A defensive back pursuing a ball carrier needs to pick an angle for the pursuit. How can they know which angle to take? And is there a way to know if they're on track to make the tackle during the pursuit? If they aren't on track, what adjustments do they need to make to still be successful? In this video, we'll develop some techniques for the defensive back that are actually usable in the heat of the game, not just when we are armchairing and have a computer to help with the calculations. Welcome back to Math the World. In this video, we are analyzing the mathematics of pursuit from the perspective of a defensive back trying to catch a ball carrier. Let's set up the problem similar to the truck evasion problem. We have a distance from the defensive back to the sideline. We'll call this distance L. We have the distance downfield from the ball carrier to the level of the DB. We will call this distance D. Let's also assume that the speeds of the two athletes are roughly equal. We'll call those speeds S. In previous videos, we built a similar mathematical model for these evasion and pursuit problems. We looked at which angle maxed out this function to help a pedestrian know which angle to take to have the best chance of avoiding an oncoming truck. But in that situation, we tried to maximize the time between the person and object getting to the same spot. But the defensive back wants this time to be zero. They want to arrive at the edge of the field at the same time the ball carrier gets to their position. So the defensive back isn't looking to maximize this equation. They're looking for the direction that makes it so their time to get to the sideline equals the ball carrier's time to get to the defensive back. Or in other words, what angle makes this function zero? We've assumed that the two athletes have the same speed. We learned in the previous videos that the relative speed is all that matters, that the distances didn't matter at all in determining the optimal angle for evading the truck. But is this true for the DB problem? Notice when we start solving for x, we're able to eliminate speed from the equation as a first step, but then quickly get stuck in solving the equation. Since our speeds are no longer in the expression, they don't matter in determining the best angle for the DB, but the distances are still in our equation and do seem to matter. This equation is beyond the solving techniques we learn in school. If we have Wolfram Alpha help us, then we can find an expression for the solutions given our two distances. But the solution is crazy and not easy to interpret. This expression inside the inverse tangent function is a little helpful. From it, we can tell that if D is about equal to L, meaning the distances from the sideline and the distance down the field are approximately the same, then the optimal angle is zero, so running perpendicular to the sideline is the best option. But we didn't need an expression to tell us that, we can get that from geometry. If the distances D and L are the same, then both players are equally distant from this spot, and they're going the same speed, so yes, that is where the DB should run. Our current mathematical model might not be much more help to us in this football problem, so let's move to a geometric model. It might teach us something about the situation that we can actually use to help coach DBs. If the two runners are the same speed, then they cover the same distance in the same amount of time. So one strategy is to find a point on the sideline that is the same distance away from both the DB and the ball carrier. The set of all points that are equal distant from these two players is a perpendicular bisector of the segment between the two players. We can draw this line segment between them, construct the perpendicular bisector, and where it intersects the sideline is the place the DB should run to. This is the soonest the DB can catch the ball carrier, again assuming that they are the same speed. This gives us the first rule of thumb for the DB. Visually estimate the perpendicular bisector of the two players' positions and go to where it would hit the sideline. In the heat of the moment, this will have to happen very quickly. Does it matter if the estimate is off one way or the other? We learned in previous videos that in the truck evasion problem, it didn't matter much. Being off by a few degrees made the same difference whether it was lower than the optimal angle or larger than the optimal angle. But here, it matters. There's no leeway for the DB if he runs too far upfield. He will miss his chance for the tackle, because the ball carrier will be past him by the time the DB gets to the sideline. So it's much better to err on running down the field. He might give up an extra yard or two, but that's better than not getting the tackle. Remember that this path is based on our assumption that the players have the same speed. If the DB is not as fast as the ball carrier, then he will need to run further downfield. On the other hand, if the DB is faster than the ball carrier, then he has some cushion and doesn't need to err on running down the field. One way to think about this isosceles triangle path is that it is the riskiest of all possible paths. It's risky because if estimated a little too far upfield, or if the ball carrier is faster than the DB, then the DB could miss the tackle. But if the DB can make the tackle on this path, it keeps the opposing team at the shortest gain possible. It's high risk, but high reward. At this point, there are two intriguing questions. Is there a way for the defensive back to know whether he's on track to make the tackle during the pursuit? And two, if there's a riskiest path, is there a safest path? We will address the second question about the safest path in another video because it uses a different line of reasoning. So let's turn to the first question. How should the DB know if he's on a collision course? The answer is by the swivel of his head. Let's assume that the DB is on the ideal path, the isosceles triangle path, and let's look at how the isosceles triangle made between the two ball carriers and the collision point changes as they run. A moment later, both players have traveled the same distance, so now the new triangle is this isosceles triangle. A moment later, it's this isosceles triangle. All of these are similar triangles, so this angle stays the same during pursuit. That means if the DB is watching the ball carrier, the rotation of his head won't change as long as he is on the ideal path. We can see this on the video clip. The angle between the head and the shoulders seems to stay constant right up until the moment of contact, showing that the DB was quite close to the ideal path. With this information, we've now figured out something that is really useful for DBs in the moment. Even if they don't use the geometry to initially pick a direction, they can pay attention to the swivel of their head as they run. If they're running in a straight line and their head doesn't swivel while they watch the ball carrier, they are golden. If their head swivels backwards, they're going too far downfield. If their head swivels forward, they're heading too far upfield. Here's an example of bad pursuit, because the head is constantly moving downfield, showing that the player is not on a collision course. The head swivel strategy is extra powerful because it doesn't rely on the assumption that both players are the same speed. No matter their speeds, this strategy still works, because the triangles formed by their distances are still similar triangles. This fact is one coaches can use in other sports as well. How can baseball players know if they're on track to catch a fly ball? Well, if players always run so the rotation and elevation of their head doesn't change as the ball comes down, then they're on a collision course with the ball. So we figured out two helpful strategies for a defensive back. First, they can use the perpendicular bisector to find the isosceles triangle path, the direction to take for the earliest possible tackle. Granted, this is a risky path. Poor estimate can cause the player to miss the tackle, which brings us to our next strategy. They can pay attention to the head swivel during the pursuit and use that to adjust their direction. Even if the DB just uses intuition to pick an angle, they should pay attention to their head swivel in order to adjust their angle as they run. This way they stay on course for the tackle. Hockey players chasing down pucks or soccer players chasing down balls or players can use the same strategy. What if a DB doesn't want to take the riskiest path but wants to take the safest path? There is another path we could call the safe path. There's a way to modify our work with the truck evasion problem to come up with a safe path for the DB that actually makes sense in this situation. But that is the focus of the next video. The link will be in the description below when it's finished. Do you have other sports situations that might be interesting to analyze? Or know of stories where mathematics or statistics changed a sport? Include them in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.